think this is the third workshop that we've done before. So just a quick introduction. I don't think there's too much introduction about Carlos Moreno. I work in the gym, etc. We've got here Mr. MSC. Mr. Miguel. Miguel's an excellent, excellent pad man. He's the best pad man I've seen. So he's going to be showing us a lot of like some of his tricks. And we've got man of these not introductions, the whole hard days. Professional boxers, everyday international chat. So we just collaborate and do a lot of work with each other. So we thought it would be good to sort of bring to hear what we do in our training as well. So today's workshop is going to be a combination of like a little bit of like reaction mitt work. I don't know if you guys have seen some of the mitt work that was very popularized by Floyd Mayweather Senior, Floyd Mayweather Junior, and Roger Mayweather. There's a reason why that pattern, that type of fight is really popular in that sort of side of boxing. But we've been working that for a number of years now, and it's very effective. There's many benefits to learning that pattern. One of the main benefits is improves your reaction in terms of defense and attack. Also, it improves your awareness as well. It allows you to get a greater field of vision for what's going on, so you're able to respond and defend without actually having to look at specific punches. So if someone's throwing three shots, I might be able to just block them without actually having to look one, two, three. So you're more effective on the counter because you know you can instinctively block without thinking, so you're not thinking about the counter punch. Okay? Also develops your timing and rhythm and good cardio as well. So I'm going to be doing that today. And later after that, if you guys are up for it, we'll be doing a little bit of like body sparring in the ring. And for those of you who have head guards and punches, you can jump in and do a bit of sparring as well. And then we'll see the chat after, so I have like energy to it. And you're going to take them on pads today, so I think so. So some of you might be taking some pads with them. So everyone's already skipped and warmed up. What I would like to do is for about 2 to 3 minutes is just so I can sort of gauge what I'm working with today, is get everyone shadow boxing for just 3 minutes just so I can see what level we're at. Following this shadow boxing, we're then gonna jump back into the ring with Miguel, myself and O'Hara, and we're just gonna demonstrate a combination. Then you're gonna get some pads on, working in pairs, pads and gloves, and then we're going through combination for a couple of rounds and switching up and explaining different things and why we do it. How's that sound? Cool. Everybody ready for some work?
Sounds good. Let's
do it. Yeah, we might get to this a little harder as you can say. Alright, let's go guys, try to box in. 3, 2, 1, let's go. Let me get some new fun. Shoulder roll before, Right, so, I'm shooting the right hand. He's gonna catch it on his shoulder, and then he's gonna use that leverage to push off the back foot, smash to get a counter. Yeah, so again, what? Nah, for those of you who haven't used the shoulder roll, it's like a block. So if you're here, no, some people will just block. They'll be like block, block, block. But when you use the shoulder, it allows you to be more versatile with your hand. So whilst I'm blocking, say you've got a jab, I'm blocking, say, so 1-2, but I'm here, my hand's occupied, yeah, trying to defend, shoot, trying to defend, and I can't use it for the counter. When he shoots the right hand and I roll it, I've got a bit of versatility now with this hand to do different things. I can shoot here, I can go there, use hand control, okay? That's why it allows you to just do more. So a boxer that has the hands here, not only that, but if I've got my hands up here and I'm jabbing from here, you can see the jab all the time. It is fast, but you can see it. Whilst if I've got my hand down here and I'm relaxed, it's very difficult to see when the jab's coming, and it's easy to shoot downstairs to the body, okay? So just one more time, information.
Then block to the body, close to the head.
So when you go body, you then go down to the waist.
So first one is that, yeah? And the second one is clap, clap, clap. Okay? This is one. Clap, clap, clap.
So, everyone's going to need gloves on this one, I think. Because now we're starting to get ready for a little bit of the light body squat. But so we're still, kind of the idea is still the same. We're still going to do a bit of technique. But now we're just doing defense. Now, okay, when you're talking about defense, do you mind turning, David, can you turn it down?
All the way down.
All the way down. I'm all the way up. Alright, this is like that. So, okay, one thing about defense in boxing, yeah? I see a lot of people, they associate, they automatically, when you say to defense, they associate it with being on the back foot or being like, there's a difference between being defensive, being a defensive fighter, and retreating. Defense and retreat are not the same thing. So you say to someone, defend, and then they're being attacked, they start going back and running away. You can defend going back. You can defend standing in the same place, you can defend going forward, okay? Learning how to defend going forward is really important and critical if you want to step up your game, right? There's nothing like being in front of a fighter who doesn't go back, doesn't back off, and he's defending all your shots, but he's walking you down. You're going to get knackered because you're throwing all these shots, and you're moving, and they're walking you down, and then your legs are starting to burn out, and now suddenly they start shooting, block, shooting, and getting you on the back foot. That's how you get stopped. Yeah, that's how elite level fighters stop other boxers. So let's do, I'm going to do different types of defense here. So I'm going to use my feet. It says three types of defense. There's hand defense, feet defense, head defense, yeah? One of the drills we use for head defense is slip drill. There's a new tutorial out on Moreno Boxing TV YouTube channel. Moreno Boxing TV, check it out. Me and Dale, we did the tutorial on how to use the slip drill. Stick like that with the glove at the end of the hand and the head, so don't watch that. So back foot, moving my feet, shooting. Most of the time, when you're on the back foot, you're going to be worried about long shots. You're not too worried about short punches. I'm sitting alert, I'm seeing everything. I'm not overreacting to shots. I'm just seeing everything, I'm not overreacting. All when I want, I can shoot, yeah, but I'm on the back foot. But you can also do it going forward. You can do it standing still, you're shooting. I'm not really watching too much what's coming. I'm just reacting naturally. Yeah, I'm not too much, yeah? Or I can start walking them down, yeah? I prefer to walk down. Walking down. Walking down. Down here. I'm not letting you go nowhere. You ain't going nowhere. Yeah. I can also counter as I'm walking them down. Back. Time. Then I have a side to pull, I might slip, yeah, to use my head defense, so hand defense, and feet. What we're going to do with your partner, okay, we're going to show you the blocks again. So with your partner, with gloves on, A's attacking, B's defending. And I want you to practice going back for a few, and going forward for a few, yeah? So when you shoot a jab, catch that jab, back, shoot across. Bar, roll out for the hook, bar, that's it. Yeah, so one shot at a time. Jab, catch, left hook, drop, right hook, overhand, good body, and every shot has a counter. Okay, so when you put it together freestyle, I'm not going to counter this shoot. Okay. Yeah, and then afterwards, after you do this round, we'll keep using the counter.